Welcome to Neurology News Network. I'm Marco Meglio. Let's get into the news from this week. The American Heart Association and American Stroke Association have issued an update to the 2018 guidelines for the early management of acute ischemic stroke, clarifying prior recommendations and taking into consideration new clinical trial data. The guidelines offer a comprehensive breakdown from symptom onset through 2 weeks post-stroke. Ultimately, the guidelines include advice for pre-hospital care, urgent emergency evaluation, and treatment with intravenous and intra-arterial therapies, as well as management during hospital stay, such as secondary prevention measures to institute within 2 weeks. Additionally, the guidelines state their support for the use of stroke systems of care in both the pre-hospital and hospital settings. According to reports, Dr. Stephen Hahn is expected to be named the new commissioner of the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. If confirmed, Hahn, who is a chief medical executive and a professor in the Department of Radiology Oncology at the University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston, will take over from Acting Commissioner Norman Sharpless, who stepped in to run the agency following the resignation of Dr. Steve Gottlieb in April. While Hahn has found much success at MD Anderson, this agency will be his first significant interaction with policy, according to a report from the New York Times. Notably, Interim Commissioner Sharpless will immediately return to his post as the director of the National Cancer Institute, while Brett Girard, an official with the Department of Health and Human Services, will step in as interim until Hahn is confirmed. The FDA has accepted Genentech's biologics license application for satralizumab based on findings from two phase 3 trials that showed effectiveness in reducing risk of relapses in patients with NMOSD. Satralizumab was previously granted breakthrough therapy designation for the treatment of NMOSD in December of 2018. The double-blind placebo-controlled studies evaluated the efficacy and safety of satralizumab over 96 weeks. Overall, 76.1% of patients assigned to satralizumab monotherapy in the Sakura Star study were relapse-free at 48 weeks, compared to 61.9% who received placebo. At 96 weeks, 71.2% of patients who received treatment with the satralizumab were relapse-free, compared to the 51.2% of patients in the placebo group. For more direct access to expert insight, head to neurologylive.com. This has been Neurology News Network. Thanks for watching.